sure how to, oh, set the hotkey. Okay, I have to set it or it's not gonna work, so. Okay, so we're gonna go here. Let's say shift. And shift again. Apply. Okay, so now it should work. Okay, so so you see the bird that I want to paint. So in any case, this time what I want to do is kind of delineate where the bird is going to be. And so I'm going to use watercolors. I'm sorry, not watercolors, but Prismacolors. How about that? For kind of doing the basic drawing. So let's see, and that way I'll have kind of an idea of where it goes. So, boy, I'm going to be using a lot of medias today. Okay, so I've got to look at this picture kind of like you would, you know, geometry sort of. So it kind of starts down here. And it ends not quite at just above the middle. So there's the middle, so right above the middle. So that's gonna be my line for the branch. And actually I wanna use a different color, maybe a lighter, because it's kind of a gray. The branch is kind of gray, so I don't want to make it. So I'm going to go from here to here. And it ends kind of closer to the corner, so we'll go like that. Width-wise, I would say it's about... somewhere around here, and then it looks like it's got a little piece of the branch that splits there, so it'll be kind of like this, and then generally like that. So you don't have to be like a great sketcher, just kind of do the lines. Okay, so see, I go up a little ways, and then it's going to be kind of like a little B. Sideways like this, and we'll go this way, and it goes like near the corner, so that might have been, yeah, that's about right. And those are a lot skinnier branches, so go like that. And then here, this one here, hold on, let me move this over and get my picture here. Okay, so this one here is, it's a separate branch, it's not part of the same one. Okay, so it's kind of going behind this one, and this is a, I don't know what you guys call it in Spanish, we call it mora, might be mulberry or something like that, but I don't know, because a mulberry is more of a bush and these are more of a tree, so I'm doing that little doodad that's on there. Now this kind of winds up a little bit less than half, somewhere in here, and not all the way to the top, kind of goes up there. And see, because that's going to have like a little bunch of little doodads there. Oh, and it looks like maybe a leaf there. And a couple of little, I guess it's where the fruits grow or the leaves grow or something. I don't know what you call them. Okay, so then here we have kind of a little loop this way, And it looks like we have, okay, so from there, where this thing was, to where it intersects, so kind of has a little bit of a curve. Doesn't have to be perfect because I'm just doing this as a reference, and right about here, well, the bird is going to be up to here and he's like just below those little, that's where his little beak is, kind of up that way. And it's kind of rounded, more rounded, and a little bit open. And then he's got a little bit of a, like a little V there. And then this goes this way. And there's like a little thingy there. All these technical terms, huh? Okay, so right where his nose is, there is a little branch, and that's important that it's there because that's where he's going for the berries. So there's another leaf going this way. You see there was a leaf there. And this one looks like a leaf aiming back at us. So it's going to be kind of like this. And kind of goes like that. And then here again, we have a little bit of a, right from where that is where one of the berries comes out. And is going to be, okay, so relative, it's about the same length as the beak, so we're going to make it about like that, and then another berry is here. And see, I thought these were cherries when I looked at it first. I thought it was cherries. It's funny. Okay, so this is going to be a leaf here. And this is going to go kind of like that. That really should have been going all the way off the page. That's okay. That would just mean I would need to make it bigger. Okay. Anyway, so something like that. And then so that we got the two. We got the leaf, and then, there's like another little thing that goes this way. Okay, so now we have this. Okay, I want to make sure you can see that leaf there. So the bird, the little beak is a little wider actually. And then his little head is kind of tilted this way. Okay. And his little eye makes like a little, it's got like a little semicircle like that. And then that little round eye inside of that. And right at the end of it, it's got like a little line that goes like that. And then here, we have a little bit of a curve. Okay, so I gotta look at the shape of the head. The shape of the head is kind of goes like that. And it's a little bit shorter here. Got a little bit of a See, okay, proportion looks a little bit big. It's okay. So he isn't gonna go all the way through the. Okay, so he's quite a bit smaller than that, actually. So this beak is way too long, is what that tells me. Okay. So let's see. Do I even have an eraser? Oh, here it is. One. Okay. All right. So, yeah, because I think that's way too big. And so since that's too big, this whole thing is wrong. So I wasn't paying attention to my proportions and you know where the other branches. So I also have to kind of look at that, how that makes a shape here as well. So it looks more like it goes kind of, you know what? His beak is actually sticking out a little closer to that. So we'll move that because right now, if you want to make any changes, the beginning of this part is crucial because the bird is the most significant part of the painting. So, and this is Prisma, it's not really just your regular pencil. So, okay. So let's see, the little beak is gonna go across this. It opens a little bit. And it's this one runs parallel to this one. Right here, kind of like. Okay. One thing about watercolors, though, is it's hard to cover it up, you know? You have to kind of get it right. Oh, he's got a little nostril right there. And how far is it? It's like almost to the end. Okay. All right. So here he goes across there. And this is shorter. Okay. It looks like his little tail is gonna go with the line of his. Oh, and there's a little branch right in front of him. Kind of goes up this way. And his little foot is kind of wrapped around it. And you can see the other little, I don't know what you call it, claw, right on the other side of it. And that right here looks like there's another, right where the tail is, there's another little piece of a branch. And right where that. So there. Oh, his other little foot is here. And let's see. Oh my goodness. Okay, let me move that picture over a little bit. Because I'm being blocked. Okay. Oh, there's more berries there. Hadn't even seen those. Hold on. Okay. There, that's better. Okay, because I've got another monitor there. That these are on. Okay. So, right here, right where his little Body reaches there, it kind of goes. Wow. From here to there. It's got a little claw. And a little skinny leg. Has another little claw. And it's kind of hidden behind a leaf. So I see one more little nail from the claw. Okay. And so from where this is, it's kind of halfway between these two, so I'm going to change where that is. Okay. So halfway between these. Oh, and actually way closer to his foot is the little part of the branch, which is going to be kind of going like this. Okay. And it's about as wide as his beak, so it's actually pretty wide. So a little nubbin, whatever you call those little doohickeys. Okay, and then here is another leaf that's kind of blocking my view. Oh, and these are cool when you do watercolors. When you do these leaves, it's really fun because you get to like do one area, skip another area, and all that. So I'm gonna have a little fun with that today. Okay, and so this actually should be wider. Okay, so then this little stick is too far now. Looks okay there. We're gonna leave it. And then here, right across here is another leaf, which is the one that goes and covers his little foot. Oops. I don't want it to completely cover it. Here we go. Gotta erase that. You only want it to half cover it. Okay, so his little toes are going to be sticking out about there. So I'm going to change the shape of this leaf a little bit so that it fits the picture. Kind of goes down, then curves up, and goes to a point. Okay. And then again, we're going to have some little veins. And let's take out the part of the foot that doesn't show. And then got a few more veins here. Yeah, these probably could be done really nicely too with the color pencils. Okay. And then this here, I think it needs to be more rounder up here. little tail goes this way and then this way. Then it has like a little V. Oh, I think it needs to be. Yeah. It makes like a little V. And either the, well, the branch probably should be a little bit wider, but I'm gonna leave it like that. I'm not worried about it. It can be whatever, you know, leaves are relative. Okay, so here, that branch is right here. It's got a lot of little shapes on it. And then his, where his head is. Okay, so I'm gonna make it rounded. And then it goes kind of like that. And then right where that curves in is where his little wing is. And that kind of just goes little skinny bit there, and then it's black, and then it looks like it's kind of straight here and then goes kind of in a little V there. So right there. And then right in front of that, he has another little bunch of white. Okay, and right where the beak is, kind of goes like this. And then it kind of goes in right there. Is it one or two? It's got like a little V. Okay, this doesn't look right to me. It's more of a upward little loop, and it meets here. Okay. Okay, so right where this is, there's a little dark area, and his eye is really close. Well, there's like a little round circle, and then his eye is inside of that. Goes to a little line. That's more of a straight line. And this is, goes all the way under. And then kind of like the little feathers in the way of the eye there. And the little sparkle of the eye is right there. Kind of a rounded triangular thing. So this is going to be dark. And then here, I need to make it a little darker. I don't know, this part here, I'm not feeling okay there. That's more like it. Okay. Alright, so then over here there's like another little bunch of one, I don't know, probably another branch. And it'll go from here. Let's see, it's got a little, looks kind of like this. And then there's another one going that way. And this one is going to have a dark side over here. Got a few little, I guess, nubs where the plant is going to grow. Okay. And then there's something on this side. Which I'm not sure what it is. But looks like it could be a leaf or something there. Okay, and in the background, I'm just gonna kind of drop stuff in there. Okay. Okay, so we got this leaf. I want to kind of get those leaves this seems a bit long. Oh, there's another leaf here, that's why. There's a leaf that goes here. That's what was throwing me off. Okay. And then here, and then this intersects down here. Okay. So this part was incorrect where it was intersecting. Should have been a little more this way. Okay, so we got a leaf there. And kind of got one back here. Oh, there's another little something or other here. Like a little piece of broken bark or something. Okay. Another leaf. We'll put it behind that one. And all the bottom of the tree. Okay. Right down here is another something or other. And here's another little something on the tree. And then also, oh, there's another tree, another leaf that comes from here, about here. Comes from another and it's kind of going under this one, but it's more of a straight, and then so these leaves actually, okay, this one, this leaf kind of has a jagged, like a jagged little edge actually. Okay, I think that's the main gist of it. And that bird looks a lot plumpier than mine, so I'm going to make him a little plumper here. He's got more of a, like a little gut here. So this goes in. So from here, I'm going to do it backwards because it's hard to. Oh, way bigger than that. Let's see, he's got that, that. I would say he's got a nice little curve here, but he's way chubbier. Not that much. Okay, so we're gonna have issues with how fat he is now. Okay. There we are. Oh, that seems about right. So then here, oh, he's got like this little pointy thing on the bottom here, and in the middle of that are the much. Seems to me like his eye should be more down because he's turning his head a little bit as he does this. So let me see. The reason I had to have that because I need to be able to delineate where the bird's gonna be, and then okay. Oh, this mouth should have been a lot closer to there. Okay. Well, I'll worry about that tomorrow. It's Scarlett O'Hara. Okay. Have a little red here, a little red here. I didn't put the little berries on there, on this branch. Oops. That's kind of significant because those are cool right there. And we have another one. Oh, hello. Ah, Patrick Mumford is on. All right. Hey, Patrick. Okay, I'm doing another one here. Okay. So these are red too. More leaves. So now that I've delineated basically where the leaves are and where, I'm just going to delineate where the branch is. And that way I can put the watercolors in the back, because I'm going to try to avoid putting it, you know, where I don't need the color. Close to him here, there's another little nubby. Bunch of little deformities in this. This I probably could have done in another color. And I don't want to forget his little foot. And me doing it in these colors kind of helps, because that way I won't lose it in the, because sometimes it's hard to see. Looks like there's a long one there. A little one here. And then another little curly one here. Okay, and then this one is right here. It's hard for me to see, to use. Was thinking about making one. Oh, enlarger? What do you mean an enlarger? No, I'm using a program called, what do you call it? Oh, OBS. Is that what you're talking about? Is that an enlarger? Easy as I was thinking. Oh, an enlarger. yeah, enlargers are actually pretty easy to use, but I'm not sure. And who wrote that? I can't see who wrote that. Okay, I can't tell. I'm sorry. So we're gonna have a little thing here, another little nubbin on that. But if you want to learn how to use an enlarger, I can help you with that. this little thing should be way higher. So I'm gonna erase it and just make it higher on the branch where I think it needs to be. There's like a little something holding on here too by a little it looks like a little piece of a branch I'm hanging on like by a spider web, which is kind of cool. Okay. So right where that thing is, another little piece comes out and kind of goes up. And it's got a couple of little nubbins. So probably going to be another growth. It looks like there's another leaf over here, or partial leaf. Okay. Okay. All right, so now, well, I didn't finish this part over here. Darn it. Looks like it could be like part of a branches of a tree or something. It's hard to tell what it is. But definitely goes into a branch. Okay. Now for the background, I'm gonna grab some water, and you know what? Let me get some clean water, cleaner. I'm trying to decide what would be the best way to mix the colors. Okay, I'm gonna do it on here maybe. Because I wanna do, this is acrylics. And I'm gonna use those as well. But I want to use watercolors right here. So let me move the pencils out of the way. Okay, so I'm going to use a little bit of water on here. And special brush. I'm going to use that one. Okay. And so I'm going to grab the colors with this. So I'm going to have different colors of greens and browns in the background. Okay. So see there. What I want to do is I want to put a little bit of water on the painting. Want that on there. Okay. So like maybe go like this. Let's see. And kind of just put colors. Let's see if I can pull it and pour it like this. Like a little dropper. All right. See what it does when I do this. Because what I want to do is have like the colors be kind of faded and spread everywhere back there. So if it's really wet, the colors tend to spread more. So that's what I'm going for right now. Let's see. Nope, that's black. I want more of a brownish. Okay. And so that's gonna be like right in here. And I'm gonna use a little water. Collect the brown. And see. Be because I want these colors in the background to be kind of mixed. So I also want them to look kind of like, I don't know, stuff in the background is just distant stuff, you know. So let me try spritzing it. Sometimes that helps. You can get some of those effects by spritzing it with water. Okay. I could also try different brush. How about this one? This one might be better for this. Because you need kind of a moppy. There we go. So you want the colors to kind of go in the background, but look kind of like mixed together, you know. Here's another green. We want a little bit of this green back here. Mixed with a brown is okay. See how these greens are complementary for the red, so it's real good to have them back there. I'm gonna get the greens on here. Oh man, I should put some of that ambient music. And you know, it's hard because you want to use music that's, what do you call it? It's, oh, it doesn't have the, oh gosh, what's that word I'm looking for? Where they don't, like somebody doesn't own the rights. I can't think of the word. Anyway. What's the word? I'm going to spritz it because, again, I'm trying to get this to just kind of mix with all this stuff. And, you know, normally you can put a little color down and throw something else, and it'll pick up the other colors and, you know, kind of blend. And I have to be careful because over there, I'm gonna take some of this out and maybe put a little different color because that's where the leaves are gonna be. And I don't really want them to be so green there. do is put a little yellow on those leaves that go this way. Because otherwise they're going to just blend in with this background, because I probably shouldn't have put so much green back in that area. Well, the a little more brown. Weird shades of green. See, that would have been a good color over here. And this would have been a good color over here. There's a little too much water in there, I think. But I do kind of want it to be a mop situation. Oh, this is going to be nice because these little thingies are red. So they'll go contrasting against these. To do is kind of mop up some of the water, but at the same time because I don't really like it when it gets so wet that it wrinkles the paper, so I have to be careful of that. I want it really wet, but I really don't want it to look, and I want it to look fussy in the background too, so thinking this will do the job. So just use whatever you got it, whatever resources you have, you know, whatever brushes, whatever works best for what you're trying to achieve. And so over here, looks like I do need some greens because it's going to be like greens, browns. Here, I'm going to mix it all on my brush. Green, brown, and yellow. And then I'm going to mix that over here. In that whole area, there was a dark brown. So soon. So I'm going to put the green there because it's going to be okay because there's little nubbins. And I kind of want that to look like little something in the background, like leaves. Okay. There's like a greenish blue that goes in there. So right about here. much I have for blue here. Blue green. I'm just throwing some water on that, which I just put there, because I want it to look kind of blended in, okay? Right in here. And I think these colors in the background make the painting, you know, I'm trying to kind of match the a little bit of the hues, because that way it'll contrast as well as it did when I saw the painting or the picture. Use brown. Okay, different shades of brown in here. Oh, it kind of wraps around the bottom as well. Okay, now this other thing here. I'm gonna have to try and match that silvery gray. Seems like that might be too brown, more like what it needs to be on the bottom. Or in the middle. And actually I've got it backwards, because the lighter color should be on the bottom. I mean on the top. Because the sun is on top, you know. So I'm gonna go ahead and put this color in there, and then I can always darken it. right there, I do have kind of like a silvery color here. Let's see how that works out. Hi. Oh, what just happened? My picture. Here, cancel. Oh boy. There it is. And there it is. You guys, if you make comments, I'll answer you after the feed because I really can't do it right now. So sorry. And it's too hard to read up there. Let me see if I can. Okay. Anyway, you guys, so I can't answer any messages right now, but feel free to leave messages on there. I can read them later. And I'm going to use this silver to bring, make it look more like the silver gray. It's like a pearl. And gonna show you how you do these leaves. And you wanna do them like a little bit different colors. And then what you wanna do is you wanna take one area. Okay. So this area on the bottom is a little bit darker. So I'm gonna take that. And then you want to get another area, but you don't want to. Okay. You don't want to get the. Like you said, you want to get the vein from here. And so again, I want to miss another spot. So you kind of like leave a spot in between, and that way it'll make veins when you add the other color. Gonna put the outside line. And then I can also put this side. And you can see I've got all these little jagged edges which I want to add also. And this one here bit greener, so I'm going to make it a little greener. And then here, I'm going to do green. And then again, another section right there. And maybe more of a yellow green over here on this part. So I want to leave an area in between. So the light green goes on the edges. And here, I've got a bunch of little sections as well. Again, I'm going to skip an area. So normally you just kind of put a little water and let it just kind of go. You're trying to get those little indentations. And so I'm gonna work on this one. This one looks more like a more like a grayish green.
do is now I'll wet this area in between. So this leaf looks like it's a little older or something. Kind of a dark one back here. And I didn't finish filling in this area here. She looks like have no idea what time it is. This is like the stuff in the background, so just kind of want to slop it around so it looks blurry. In that area, we want more of a brown color. for the tail. doing it with watercolor, but if it doesn't dry red enough, I'm probably gonna add some alcohol inks. So I'm mixing all these reds together to give it a intense red. I was gonna go all the way to the edge, but I noticed it looks more orangey on the edge. So, I guess it's more like a cad red right there. So I'm gonna put this red in there. And then here, it's straight up orange. These reds. I can always go back and layer colors. Oh, thank goodness that's a red, because and it's supposed to be black right there. And I didn't notice that I painted over it. lovely. Okay, this goes here.
guess I'm gonna leave it there. And if I, however it dries, I'm not sure what I'm gonna do tomorrow. But doesn't seem maybe quite bright enough. But that's what watercolor does, so. Oops. Trying to wipe the brushes. Alright, anyway, so that's it for now. And thanks for watching. If you're on Facebook, please comment. Share if you want. Save it. Alright, I'm gonna stop recording here. And okay. Hey Lucy. Guys. Oh, I gotta turn off the one up here. All right. Well, good night. I'm gonna turn it off. And I'll take a picture of this and show it. Where's my phone? Oh, there it is. Mm-hmm. Okay.
my goodness. I thought I stopped screaming.